Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of Connect. My name is Adrian and we're on site to talk about BAW acoustic wave technology from Texas Instruments, essentially taking an external crystal and integrating that into our wireless microcontrollers. And to dive deeper into that topic, we're bringing in Habib Mohammed from our hardware R&D team. So really excited to have you on board today.
You're welcome, Adrian.
And I know we got a lot of machinery back here, but Before we transition, can you talk a little bit about what BAW is?
Yeah, so BAW stands for bulk acoustic wave, as you just mentioned. It basically, it's based on TI MEMS technology, which it has a piezoelectric material, which is sandwiched between two electrodes. And this material converts the electrical energy to mechanical acoustic energy, and thereby producing stable oscillations.
Okay, and that's what is going to provide your system some level of timing.
Yeah, that's what the clock provides the system. That's the reference clock that gives the overall clock for the system.
Very cool. And why should customers care about integrating an external crystal into their microcontroller?
Yes, so TI BAW technology provides significant performance benefits for the IoT products that are operating under vibrations and mechanical shock conditions. For example, let's take automated factory. So over there, don't you want to know the performance of the parts ahead of the time when they are exposed to the mechanical vibrations or shock conditions, such that we can replace those parts ahead of the time? That is called as predictive maintenance, right? And that will help us with any factory downtimes which could come in future with those fatigue parts.
Gotcha. So with a BAW-enabled microcontroller, you know, we could affix this to a vibrating motor or a pump and actually be able to determine if a part is going bad before it actually goes bad.
Yes. And you will see that the way the performance right now in the demo that we will show you.
Very cool. So what we'll be demonstrating here today is looking at how our devices are robust and are able to operate through harsh conditions like vibration and shock.
Exactly. So we are using military standard 883 method 2002 that exposes the parts to acceleration force of 1500 G.
Oh, wow.
And we'll be using BAW CC2652RB, which is based on BAW technology and an external quartz crystal solution, and we will compare these two radios under the shock conditions, and
awesome.
You will see the significant performance improvement the customers can get by using the BAW technology.
Very cool. And what's so critical about being able to operate through vibrations and shock? You know, what could happen to my application if I'm not, I guess, keeping that in mind in my design?
Yes, it is very critical, very important for a stable communication, for the link to maintain, the clocks are stable. And the main source of the clock comes from the crystals, quartz crystals, or the BAW technology that we are using, and that has to be stable. And these MEMS crystals are prone to any like external disturbances. So if there is any vibrations or any shocks, external vibrations or noise, that get coupled into the package, and that degrades that reference clock performance, and that will degrade overall system clock performance.
Love it. So I know with BAW, a lot of the times we associate it to smaller form factors, simpler hardware design, because we're integrating the crystal, but the benefits go much beyond that.
Yes, exactly.
Awesome, very cool. And I know we got a big machine here to talk a little bit about how we're able to survive, I guess, through these 1500 Gs of force.
Yes, Adrian. So this is our shock setup. We have programmed this machine, and we'll be dropping the part with an acceleration force of 1500 G, and you will go ahead and see that.
Awesome, I'm looking forward to it. So I guess step one is we got to put in our earplugs, right? It's gonna be a pretty noisy demo.
It is loud, believe me, we have to put our earplugs.
All right, so we've got our ear protection in, safety first. Habib, tell us a little bit more about what we're about to run through.
Sure, so what we're gonna do, you will be starting the setup.
Okay.
So you need to turn on the knob to up.
All right.
So you will see that we have mounted 2652RB on the board, it will drop down.
Okay.
At the point of impact, this is signal source analyzer. We have triggered it to that machine. At the point of impact, this will measure the frequency, how much it deviates. So right now we are transmitting 24, the radio is at 2440 megahertz, and at that frequency, radio frequency, we will see how much the frequency is deviated at the point of impact.
Awesome, looking forward to it. So we're gonna do this twice, once with the BAW solution and once without the BAW solution.
Exactly.
Awesome, very cool. Well, let's go ahead and put the other half in. And we'll go ahead and turn this switch here, is that right?
Yep.
All right, I'll give it a count of three. What do you say?
Yeah, turn this
guy. All right, one, two, and three.
So this is the capture that we just got, and you can see the at 2440 megahertz, hardly the frequency is deviated using the BAW part. Now you will see the same plot with the external crystal.
Very cool. Yeah, I almost don't see anything at all here, so that's that's very impressive. Alrighty, let's go ahead and switch the machine over to the non-BAW enabled solution.
Sure.
Alrighty, so now we're going to do it with the non-BAW enabled solution. So let's go ahead and turn it on here.
Yep. Over here you can see Adrian now. See the same frequency that is drifted, and it's so much drift when compared to the BAW solution.
Right.
So, and this is the advantage of adopting BAW technology over external crystal.
Awesome. I learned a lot, and it's really cool to see BAW enabling such important solutions in industrial factory scenarios. When it comes to predictive maintenance, I know that's something that a lot of our developers and customers are looking for. So glad to see that we're innovating in so many different ways to allow those solutions to happen. So thanks so much for joining us today.
Thank you.
And thank you all for watching. Be sure to tune in next week. We'll have more SimpleLink experts talking about innovative solutions just like bulk acoustic wave technology from Texas Instruments. So thanks so much, and we'll catch you guys next time.